Recently, somebody asked a question on Reddit Sales. It was about LinkedIn content. The question says, does posting LinkedIn content help or hurt your pipeline? I'm considering posting LinkedIn content regularly about sales, my industry, and motivation. A bit hesitant because I'm concerned it may come off as too salesy to prospect. Especially if I create posts about hitting your numbers, persevering through rejection, prospecting fearlessly, etc., etc. What are your thoughts? Well, I have some thoughts on this. Believe you me, I got some good thoughts on this, and I'm going to share them with you in this episode. This episode is brought to you in part by Sales Success Summit. If you're a sales rep and you're looking for ways to improve your skills, you want to learn from the top 1% of sellers, you need to attend Sales Success Summit. The event is held this year, October 14th through 15th in Austin, Texas. To find more information, visit the show notes or go to top1summit.com. Again, top1summit.com. This episode is also brought to you in part by TSE Certified Sales Training Program. Learn how to find more ideal customers, build stronger value, close more deals. There are 12 modules available in the program. The first two modules are absolutely free. Test them out for yourself. Go to thesalesevangelist.com/free course. Hey, 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 everyone. Welcome to another great episode of the Sales Evangelist Podcast. I'm your host, Donald Kelly, the Sales Evangelist, and I'm so excited for another great episode. I'm so excited to be here with you today. And as you heard in the teaser, we're going to talk today about this question that was posed on Reddit Sales. Should I post content on LinkedIn or not? Is it going to hurt my pipeline? This is such a good question, and this is why I decided to answer it, because I've asked myself this question, not necessarily in the sense of maybe it'll hurt my pipeline, but it was more so the fear of producing content. And I could have used many of these other reasons as excuses, but it was just fear that people were going to reject my stuff. They're not going to like it. It's going to not come across like some of these other industry experts. So who am I to talk about document management on LinkedIn? Fill in the blank for whatever industry you're in. But my answer to this question is plain and simple. Yes, you should be posting as well as engaging with content by other people on LinkedIn. Because here's what it looks like and what it seems like. Many of us go on LinkedIn and it's kind of like that middle school prom, right? Where we're all sitting against the sidelines and we're just looking at each other and we'll just say a couple things to a few of our friends like, hey, what's up, man? How you doing? And we let everybody else, those people who are just the dancers who are out in the middle, they're doing all the dancing. But we don't want to look stupid. So we'd rather look stupid sitting on the sidelines next to the punch with all of our friends and just kind of point at people and talk and make silly remarks. And you have some people who are just trolls and they're just going to go around. They can't dance at all, but they're just going to go around and make fun of everybody because they are idiots. So think about it like that as well. And I feel that the majority of sales reps, I'm being truthful, many of us, we're sideliners. We don't create content and we definitely don't engage a lot with content. Now, let me back up and define engaging real quick. I'm not talking about simply going around and just liking a couple things and just saying hi and moving on. That's kind of like, again, being at the prom, seeing your friend dancing in the middle and just kind of say, hey, nodding and moving away. You're giving your approval of that. That's not engagement. It's not sustaining or worthwhile engagement. It's just there. What would be a great engagement is you getting on a dance floor too. Or you might say, dang, bro, that move is sick. I like that. Where'd you learn that? You know what? Hey, Lewis, come over here. Check out this move that David just did. Man, that is sick, man. That's what I'm talking about, engaging. Now you're becoming this life of the party. You're bringing other people. So let's give you an example. You see someone post something in an industry. Maybe it's about, I don't know, you're in a water industry. So water purification tablets are dangerous. And then you have some other people that maybe wrote about it or somebody else that shared another piece about that. You might tag them. Hey, Megan, I saw this post, thought about you, and you tag Megan in it. The author of that piece is going to be like, dang, that Donald guy is pretty cool. He just brought somebody else over to my page. Somebody did this to me on Facebook today. Some dude was asking about who wants to make money in sales on Facebook. Then one of my good friends, he went ahead and mentioned me. Now, obviously, I'm making good money in sales and I'm not trying to join any gimmicks or anything like that. But the fact is, that was engagement. That was that person who wrote that post is now looking at my friend and saying, cool, you just brought somebody over here. And now cool, now I'm here and I'm interacting with it. So that is engagement. Again, liking is good, but going and engaging and creating and talking to people, creating that bond, that's a little bit deeper. So let's go back to our question posed by our friend. Now he's saying, well, you know, I want to post this stuff, but I just don't want to look salesy, man. I don't want to hurt my pipeline. I don't want prospect to say, oh no, there's little Lewis again posting something about motivation and about, you know, talking about himself and about his business. I don't want to talk to him. That's what he's afraid of. But the likelihood of that happening is very slim, very slim. Can I say that it could happen? Of course it could, but in most cases, it's not a big deal. I would say, look at your newsfeed right now. You see some similar faces over and over and over again, but you don't get annoyed by them. You don't read everything about them, but that name or that brand is going to stick in your mind. So when you need something or when something else, maybe they post once a week or maybe twice a week, but when they do post something, and you know it grabs your attention, you're going to say, oh, cool, that these guys are clear winners. Now, you may not read everything again that they post in detail, but one of those posts are going to jump out, and you're going to be like, dang, that is cool stuff. The moment they stop posting, you're going to be like, okay, where's brand A? Oh my goodness, where did Donald go? He's no longer posting stuff, so I guess his business shut down. Want to keep producing and posting and engaging with being out there engaging and creating this content because you stay top of mind. And that's really one of the big deals, the big reasons why you want to do this stuff. So the first part, don't worry, you're not going to be salesy. You're not going to be like all like that and be disrespected in the mind of your buyers. Now, the other part to this is that you need to make sure the content you do post, however, is going to the right audience. So if you're going to post stuff about motivation, about sales, think about this. That content should be geared towards your prospect. You get me? So if you're posting and saying, you know, like if I'm posting about sales stuff, then I am targeting towards sales individuals, towards salespeople. I want to inspire them and so forth. Fantastic. That works. But if my audience are the decision makers at, you know, Fortune 500 companies, or maybe they're mid-level management, mid-sized companies, then it probably wouldn't be the best thing to post content about myself and about motivation and things like that. I want to post what they want to hear. So that's the only part that I would tell you in that question, is to make sure that you're gearing your content towards the people you want to attract, because that's ultimately what it is. It's when we're going on a dance floor and we're doing our thing, you know, you're getting down and, you know, whatever breakdancing or whatever move you're trying to do, if you're doing that move, it should be to attract maybe the female or girl, somebody else on the other side of the room. And, you know, it might say, oh, man, look at old Lewis over there dancing real good. I want to go talk to him. He looks cool. I got the Stranger Things mentality going on because I just finished up season 3, which is pretty amazing, by the way. So if you guys want to go chill and watch that, you could go do that. But after you listen to this episode. And that actually ties to one of the reasons why many of us don't post on LinkedIn, is because we don't want to look stupid. We fear that we're going to sound like this. We're going to sound bad to our prospect. We fear that maybe our information isn't cool enough. We fear that I don't know how to create information. We fear I don't know what to post. You know, we have all these fears, but again, it really comes back down to understanding who you're targeting, who you want to attract, and then you can start creating content towards those individuals. Really, really simple and really, really easy. And I'm going to give you some ideas today. I'm going to give you a challenge, actually, and I want you guys to take part in it, to test it out and try it. Before I give you those ideas, though, I want you to listen to this. This is back in episode 1085 on our podcast. That's episode 1085. In this episode, I got content from this article. One of my friends, Stephen Hart, shared it with me, but check this out. It was 48 eye-opening LinkedIn stats for B2B marketers in 2019. And one of the things that points out is that there are 36 billion impressions per month on LinkedIn. That's 468 billion per year. Per week, that goes down to 9 billion impressions. That's how many times the content is seen. Now, you're probably saying, well, that's pretty darn cool numbers there, Donald. So you're going to say, well, what does that have to do with anything? Check this out. How many people are on LinkedIn? 500 million people are on LinkedIn, and a fraction of them are active, right? Just understand, listen to me for a second. Only 3 million, 3 with an M, million people share content weekly. So those 3 million people who are sharing content weekly on LinkedIn, that's about 1% of all monthly users sharing content. Only 1%. Because why? All of us are afraid. So we're sitting on the sidelines and 1% of the people are in the middle getting all of the freaking attention. And you or me are just wallflowers sitting on the side, being ignored, camouflage with the punch. The barrier is not too high. You can easily step over it and you can easily start sharing stuff. Now, this is what I want you guys to realize. Now, when you're sharing content, What should you share? We mentioned this already. Target it towards your ideal customer, people you want to grab the attention of, but you don't just want to, if I'm in a water purification industry, I'm not going to just post a bunch of stuff about water purification. I want to post things that my prospect, those people, will more than likely want to get. One of the recommendations that I would tell you is that, yeah, you should find industry-related stuff. I'm sure there's an industry-related magazine or association and they post content. You probably could glean some of those content and share certain things that tie back to your industry. It doesn't necessarily have to tie back to your company and towards your product, because just understand when you're sharing stuff, they're going to see you. The next thing you can do is answer frequently asked questions, because I guarantee you if one person is asking that question or a few people ask that question, a large number of individuals are asking that same question. Just like with this particular episode, I'm sure many of you had questions about LinkedIn, and now you're hearing this, you're like, oh crap, well I could do this too then, it's not that difficult. So get those frequently asked questions and share content, share the answers. Don't share it in a way like, oh, I'm going to give them only a part and they're going to have to come back and get the rest. Give it, give them a full answer. People will recognize that. They'll see your credibility. They'll see that you have no tricks up your sleeve and they'll trust you more. I'm telling you, it works. This episode is probably going to be one of our close to our 1200th episode or high 1100s, right? Now for us, we've posted the content for like the past five. This is going on our sixth year. It's a full-time gig for me. And also we have team members that get benefited and get income from this as well. So think about it on that side, that someone started sharing content and a business created from it. You just got to do it. People will come to you. People will ask questions. People will want to buy stuff. It's just a natural way of how it happens. And the other part to this too is that it's not going to happen overnight. It's going to take time, but you have to start. So one type of content is your industry-related content, things that are interesting in your industry, your prospects would want to learn about that. You could be the source of sharing that and putting it in a unique way that maybe they didn't necessarily understand. Number two, you can answer frequently asked questions. Every time a buyer asks a question, I want you to write that down, put it in Evernote, put it in Google Docs, wherever you keep track of your information or jot things down. And then you can go back to that as a source of content that you can create. LinkedIn also has a neat feature now where you can do videos and you can put some text and some GIFs and all kinds of stuff on top of that video. And this could be all done from your smartphone. It is not too complicated. While you're in a car, you're going to the next appointment and you got to the parking lot, you got a question or a thought in your mind, go ahead and create a quick video, answer that question. Or maybe you leave an appointment, a prospect ask a question. You're like, dang, that's a good one. I'm sure many people have that. Let me go ahead and answer it or think about it, the answer on the way to your next appointment, and then record that while you in the parking lot going into the next meeting. Easy stuff. The third type of content you can share are complementary content. So let's say, for instance, I'm in a sales training space, but I'm not going to share every post about sales training. However, maybe I can share things related to my ideal customer, those sales managers and those entrepreneurs or small businesses. Maybe something about CRM. Maybe I can go and find, this is nothing to do with my business per se, but if I go and share with them five CRMs that I really like and I think could be beneficial for you and your small team, that's good content for someone. And I can do that in a simple video. I can just share the links, or I can do a long form blog post. Go onto my go to my LinkedIn profile and type which CRMs are the best for small businesses. And then, you know, maybe answer the question by typing it out. Now, I recommend these three. These are free. Here's the fourth one. Here's the fifth one. It's a little premium. Here's why I like them. Answering two to three sentences. But then now that's a piece of content. It's complimentary. If somebody buys one of those CRM, it has nothing to do with me at all. I get no benefit from it. I have something to lose because I use my time, but I have nothing to gain, really. It's just me being helpful to my ideal customer. And a final type of content, you can go ahead and just take that from your company's blog. If you guys have a blog, they share stuff. You could probably take that and repurpose it and put it into a LinkedIn article. And then you can have that as a post as well. But that's what I would do. And then the other part to this is that you can engage or ask people questions. If I have certain prospects and folks I have relationship built with on LinkedIn, maybe clients, I can ask them questions. So if I say, you know, the CRM one, the top five CRM, then I can say, Dave, Lisa, Mary, that's me tagging them in the post or in the comments and say, hey, what CRM do you guys use? Now they can share their CRM and that's going to build engagement. And all of a sudden now the posts start getting some traction, get some more impression, get more visibility. When people like it or comment and they're not my direct connection, then I can go ahead and do a connection request, start the conversation in inbox. And next thing you know, we have an appointment. I cannot tell you how many times this has worked for me. I know it can work for you as well, but that's how I would use it. And I recommend you take advantage of it again. Mike, answer to this question, yes, by far you should be sharing content. The type of content gives stuff that your ideal customers want. If you don't know what to share, go ahead and try one of those different strategies or different categories that I shared. You can do stuff that are industry related. You can answer frequently asked questions. You can also do complimentary stuff, or you can just take stuff from your company's website and repurpose that and share it. Now, here's the challenge. The challenge that I have for you for the next week, each day, I want you to share one of these things. And I would say start off with an industry piece of content. Find a top industry site, the most reputable site in your industry, and then find something interesting in one of their articles or some kind of stat or something new and share that. And then you can ask a question. You can ask some of your teammates, some people that you know on LinkedIn, ask them to interact with this post and to answer the question for you as well. On Tuesday, what you can do is answer a frequently asked question. You can do this one in the form of a post. Just write out the answer. I'm sure you get it all the time from buyers who are asking about the software you sell or a service that you offer. Just go ahead and write out that question and then answer it. On Wednesday, I want you to make a video. And this video is just going to be you talking to the camera, and I want you to answer another frequently asked question. Share that sucker on LinkedIn. Number four, I want you to share complimentary stuff. Just like I talked about with the example with sales training and CRM software, think about your industry. What are some complimentary companies that you could give shout outs to? Or tools that your potential customer could benefit from, but they're industry related. They're not your competitor, but they're industry related. And finally, on day five, which would be a Friday, I want you to share something that your company has created. Maybe they wrote a blog post, or they have a video, or they have a YouTube video if you're president talking or whatever. Take that piece of content, share it, make it in a way that it's nice. So if your company's CEO is saying something about the organization, you can say, hey, a lot of people ask us who we are and why we got involved in this particular industry. Here's what our CEO has to say about it. And it's a simple video, but you're sharing that piece of content. Now, at the end of that week, if you're not getting any impression, if you didn't get anyone liking that content or anyone new looking at your stuff or, you know, commenting or liking, continue to do it. But I guarantee you're going to find new people. And when those people interact and their second degree connection, ask them for a connection request. You can say, hey, Mary, I saw that you interacted with a post that I shared on Tuesday about blah, blah, blah. Would love to connect. Or I usually say permission to connect here on LinkedIn. And they'll say, of course, now you can start that conversation. Boom. Do that. Come back. You can also tag me in one of those posts. I'd love to, you know, comment as well, that you can, or engage with your piece of content. I want to be cool. I want to be on the dance floor as well. So you can do that with me. Engage, and I will engage back. I share stuff like this, answer these questions, help you out, because I want you to be successful. I've been there and I'm still there, and I want to help you as much as I can. Give you what I know. As I do this, my goal is that you find more ideal customers, that you build stronger value, that you close more deals, but that you challenge yourself each and every single day to go out and do big things. Stay tuned for a scene from our next episode.
If lions had a very similar social capabilities as we as humans do, and where we think, we speak, we process thoughts in a different way, they would naturally feel down on themselves every time they miss that catch of prey. Because remember, for them is actual food. For them is actual survival. And it should be for us as well. But if they don't, they starve, right? But they're hunters.
Hey, I hope you enjoyed this episode today as much as I did. And if so, I ask that you go ahead and leave us a 5-star rating and review on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, or wherever you listen to fine podcasts. Show your friends and other sales reps how they can subscribe as well. Our episode was produced by myself and the Sales Podcast Network. It was edited and mixed together by the one and only Jershon O'Bail. Our podcast guest corresponder is May Marr. Our show note creator was Rael. The wonderful artwork was created by Desson. Our podcast production coordinator is Mrs. Shannon Rasmussen. You can find audio credits to this and all of our episodes in each of our show notes. And as always, I am your host, your coach, your mentor, your guide down the sales journey, Mr. Donald C. Kelly, the sales evangelist. Sales Podcast Network.